Hello everyone, today we'll discuss the part 52 of the important notes for biochemistry, and today we will discuss about the water soluble vitamins. First of all, very important thing is that all the vitamin B complexes and vitamin C, they are water soluble vitamins, and rest all vitamins are water insoluble or fat soluble. First of all, we have the vitamin B1, that is thiamine. The active form of vitamin B1, it is the thiamine pyrophosphate. The functions performed by the vitamin B1 are oxidative decarboxylation reaction. Now this transketolase enzyme is basically a thiamine pyrophosphate or vitamin B1 dependent enzyme, and this transketolase enzyme basically links the pentose phosphate pathway with the glycolytic pathway. Also, phosphorylation of the chloride channel in the brain is done by the vitamin B1. The deficiency of the vitamin B1 causes, first of all, beriberi. Beriberi can be of two types, dry beriberi or wet beriberi. So in the dry beriberi, very important thing is that there is peripheral neuropathy is seen. Also, there is difficulty in the walking and paralysis of the leg occurs. There is reduced knee jerk and other tendon reflexes, and also wrist or foot drop occurs. In the wet beriberi, there is cardiomyopathy seen. So remember, in the dry one, there is peripheral neuropathy, while in the wet beriberi there is cardiomyopathy, and because of the cardiomyopathy, edema is seen in the wet beriberi, especially in the legs and also in the trunks, face, etc. Also, there is congestive heart failure seen. Also, the deficiency of vitamin B1 causes Wernicke-Korsakoff syndrome, which is a neurological disorder. This Wernicke-Korsakoff syndrome has basically two phases, that is acute phase and the chronic phase. Acute phase, over here Wernicke's encephalopathy is seen, while in the chronic phase Korsakoff psychosis occurs. Now for the assessment purpose, so over here the RBC transketolase activity is to be determined for the biochemical assessment of the deficiency of vitamin B1. Now how we will differentiate the Wernicke's encephalopathy and the Korsakoff psychosis? So over here there is mnemonics for these two. You have to remember the coat rack mnemonic. So first of all, in the Wernicke encephalopathy, there is COAT, that means confusion occurs, ophthalmoplegia occurs, ataxia, and the thiamine deficiency is seen in the Wernicke encephalopathy, that means the acute phase of the Wernicke-Korsakoff syndrome. While for the Korsakoff psychosis, remember the mnemonics RAC, R-A-C-K, that means retrograde amnesia, enterograde amnesia, confabulation, and the Korsakoff psychosis. So just remember this mnemonics, it will be easier for you. Now next is the vitamin B2, that is riboflavin, or we can say Warburg yellow enzyme. Now the active form over here includes FMN or FAD. The functions performed by B2 includes the electron transferring. Deficiency of B2 causes ariboflavinosis. So these are the pictures of the ariboflavinosis occurs due to the deficiency of the vitamin B2 or riboflavin. Also, deficiency causes dermatitis, angular stomatitis or chilosis. For detecting the deficiency of the vitamin B2, RBC glutathione reductase is assessed. The vitamin B2 endogenously is synthesized by the bacterial flora. Now next is the vitamin B3, that is niacin, nicotinic acid or nicotinamide. The active form of vitamin B3 is NAD+ or NADP+. The functions performed by B3 includes the electron transferring. Deficiency of vitamin B3 causes the pellagra. And in the pellagra, the symptoms includes the diarrhea, dementia, dermatitis, or even death can occur because of pellagra. These are the patients suffering from the pellagra. And as you can see over here, this is known as the Kessel's necklace. And these are the dementia. Tryptophan basically synthesizes the vitamin B3. 60 mg of the tryptophan synthesizes 1 mg of niacin. Now next is the vitamin B5, that is pantothenic acid. The active form of vitamin B5, it is the coenzyme A or acyl carrier protein. Now vitamin B5 is actually an acyl carrier. It also takes part in the TCA cycle or even in the heme synthesis pathway. Deficiency of the vitamin B5 occurs very rarely, but if it occurs, it will cause the burning feet syndrome, that is known as the Grierson-Gopalin syndrome. Vitamin B5 contains the beta-alanin in its structure. Vitamin B5 is present in the coenzyme A and in the acyl carrier protein. So these are the pictures of the burning feet syndrome or the Grierson Gopalan syndrome. Now next is the vitamin B6, that is the pyridoxine or pyridoxamine or pyridoxal. The active form of vitamin B6, it is the pyridoxal phosphate or PLP. The functions include the transamination, simple decarboxylation reaction or the transsulfuration. Deficiency of the vitamin B6 causes neurological manifestations or epileptic convulsions in the infants. Deficiency can be induced by the isoniazid. Now next is the vitamin B7, that is vitamin H or biotin. The active form of vitamin B7, it is the biocytin, that is the biotin plus L-lysine. The functions over here includes carboxylation reactions or the regulation of the cell cycle. Deficiency of the biotin causes the Leiner's disease and also exfoliative dermatitis occurs. So as you can see over here, these are the symptoms of the patient suffering from the biotin deficiency, including the conjunctivitis, dermatitis, easy peeling of the skin, then the brittle nails. These all are the symptoms over here. Consumption of the raw egg white can induce biotin deficiency. Why? Because in the raw egg white, there is a glycoprotein present named as avidin. And this avidin has a strong affinity for the biotin, leading to deficiency of the biotin in the body. Now next is the vitamin B9, that is the folic acid. The active form of folic acid, it is the tetrahydrofolic acid or tetrahydrofolate, same thing. The functions of the vitamin B9 includes, it basically acts as a carrier of one carbon unit and also helps in the synthesis of methionine, purine and thymidine monophosphate. The deficiency of vitamin B9 causes the megaloblastic anemia and also neural tube defect. I have made a separate video on megaloblastic anemia, so if you want to know more about this anemia, check that out. Deficiency of the folic acid basically accumulates the formaminoglutamic acid or the FIGLU. Diagnostic test for the folic acid deficiency, it is the histidine load test. Now what actually happens over here is, because of the deficiency of the folic acid in the body, there is accumulation of the formaminoglutamic acid occurs in the body, and because of this there is increased excretion of this FIGLU in the urine. And this all is basically done and diagnosed by the help of histidine load test. Now next is the vitamin B12, that is cobalamin. Active form of vitamin B12, it is the methylcobalamin and the deoxyadenosyl cobalamin. The functions of the vitamin B12 includes that it acts as a cofactor for various reactions in various enzymes, that is in the methionine synthase, in the leucine aminomutase, and in the methylmalonyl-CoA mutase. In these enzymes, this particular vitamin B12 acts as a cofactor. Deficiency of the vitamin B12 basically causes the hyperhomocysteinemia, pernicious anemia, megaloblastic anemia, dementia, and the spinal degeneration. Now how the hyperhomocysteinemia basically occurs in the vitamin B12 deficiency? So for this, look at over here. As you can see, the homocysteine is converted into the methionine over here in the presence of methionine synthase name enzyme. And over here, the vitamin B12 basically acts as a cofactor for this particular enzyme, I told you before also. So what they will do? They will convert the methyl tetrahydrofolic acid into tetrahydrofolic acid. And this methyl is transferred to the homocysteine and converting it into methionine. But because of the deficiency of the vitamin B12, what will happen? This particular conversion of the homocysteine to the methionine is not done, and so there is hyperhomocysteinemia is seen in the vitamin B12 deficient patient. Also, very importantly, vitamin B12 deficiency causes the pernicious and the megaloblastic anemia. I have discussed about these two anemias in detail in my previous video, so just check that out. Folate trap occurs due to the deficiency of the vitamin B12 in the body. In the pernicious anemia, the vitamin B12 is given to the patient orally or by the way of intramuscular injections. Now next we have is the other water-soluble vitamin, that is the ascorbic acid. The active form of vitamin C, it is the ascorbic acid. The functions performed by the vitamin C are, it basically acts as an antioxidant and it is also a cofactor for hydroxylation reaction, including proline to the hydroxyproline conversion and also lysine to the hydroxylysine conversion. In these two reactions, this vitamin C actually acts as a cofactor. Deficiency of the vitamin C causes the scurvy. As you can see over here, this patient is suffering from the scurvy. Vitamin C can cross placenta. So today up till here, we will complete the further topics in our further videos. Thank you so much.